men and women on the prowl play a game of cat and mouse, sizing up each other's sex appeal while trying to promote their own. The more common name for this game? Flirting.
All right, so how do I flirt? Not a bad flirt. I tend to smile a lot, so that happens. I play with my hair.
I'm not the aggressive type, so I sit back and maybe try to catch some eye contact.
I have the long hair, so I usually toss that around a little bit and give my sexy eye.
It's a game we instinctively know how to play. And nowhere is it played more urgently than at a speed dating session.
I'm extremely strong, like, on the outside, but I need, like, an emotional support.
I would like to learn how to tango.
Very strong.
Is that where you went to school?
Marty Hazelton studies speed dating from an evolutionary point of view.
Speed dating is men and women competing with one another in order to impress the most attractive members of the opposite sex.
The goal of each sex is to find a good partner, but their methods differ.
Men talk about their occupations, talk about their jobs, where they got their degrees. Women may be amping up signs that they are attractive, indications of youth.
Hazelton's research has tried to predict the outcome of speed dates by looking at facial expressions. She found that only one gender actually showed its cards.
A naive observer who's just viewing a videotape of the man interacting with a woman could guess at an above chance level whether he's really interested in her, but he could not guess whether the woman was interested in the man.
Most of what a man needs to know about a woman is obvious. Her face and body are billboards for her genetic health. But because women look beyond genes, they care about a man's status and resources, and that information has to be teased out.
Women are seeking to elicit information to assess how good of a mate he might be. So they act like they're interested, ask lots of questions, and what is men's response? To do some peacocking, in a sense.
We've all seen it happen. Men think women are into them, and they're usually wrong.
Yeah, I'd probably do it again. It was a fun experience.
It was amazing. The ladies are good.
I don't know if I will be doing this again.
But it turns out men can't be blamed for thinking they're God's gift to women.
You ask a man to assess her level of sexual interest, and he will tend to rate it on the medium to high side. You ask a woman to assess the level of sexual interest, and she'll assess it on the medium to low side. The evolutionary explanation for this is that for men, underestimating a woman's sexual interest, that actually could result in a missed reproductive opportunity, which had huge costs in the evolutionary currency of reproduction.